Top 10 inflammatory foods to avoid and boost immune system. So we have been hearing a lot about inflammation. It is the inflammation which puts our immune system at risk and we lose the ability to fight viruses and germs. The people with weak immune system are hit hard by the virus pandemic. Chronic inflammation causes so many illnesses and chronic diseases like diabetes, heart disease, and arthritis. I have already uploaded a video on vitamin D deficiency, which triggers inflammation. This video is about inflammatory foods that are known to cause inflammation. The immune system treats these foods as harmful and triggers inflammation to save the cells from damage or death. If you avoid these foods, you can reduce the inflammation and boost immunity. Typically, all of these foods are gonna cause some level of inflammation anyway. But some of these might affect you more than others. Number 1. Refined sugars. Refined sugars like table sugar, sucrose, and high fructose corn syrup are the major culprits. When you eat them, these are made available to your body instantly. And body tries to convert these to other forms like glycogen and fat, and stores it for later use, and you start becoming obese and overweight. But this capability of the body is very limited. It burdens your body, and over time this mechanism fails, and sugar becomes high in the bloodstream. This is where the immune system kicks in and releases inflammatory substances to save the cells from death. And you get chronic inflammation and related chronic conditions like fatty liver, diabetes, insulin resistance, cancer, chronic kidney disease, heart disease, and many more. So stop taking foods like candies, sodas, pastries, cakes, cookies, donuts, and a lot of sugary breakfast cereals. Number 2. Trans fats. The second type of foods to avoid are trans fats. Trans fats are artificially created, unlike naturally occurring fats, which come from plants. Trans fats cause inflammation in the fat tissues, which causes heart problems and arthritis going forward. Trans fats increase the shelf life of prepackaged foods. So avoid prepackaged baked foods like pastries, cakes and muffins, cookies and donuts. Anything that says partially hydrogenated oils on the label is going to have a trans fat in there. Number 3. Refined carbohydrates. Refined carbohydrates lack some key ingredients. They take natural carbohydrates foods and strips it of all of its important nutrients like minerals, vitamins, fiber, and all the good stuff that food is supposed to provide you for healthy function of the body. Refined carbs have a higher glycemic index score. They spike the blood sugar levels and increase inflammation. So you need to avoid foods like breads, pastas, chips, pizza, candy, breakfast cereals, cookies and sodas. And avoid many other foods that contain a lot of processed sugar or processed flour. Just go for the foods that have whole grains and that are not processed. Eat more fruits and vegetables to get essential minerals, vitamins, fiber, and other nutrients. Number 4. Processed meats. Processed meats are highly associated with heart disease, obesity, and different types of cancer. These are not liked by your stomach or colon because of how they are processed and how these are cooked at higher temperatures. It is common to add preservatives like nitrates and nitrites, which cause cancer. They definitely cause inflammation in our bodies. Foods that are in this category would include hot dogs, cold cuts, bacon, sausage, smoked meat, deli meat, and packaged seafood. However, not all of those are bad for you. Just look for organic foods and avoid taking foods that contain nitrates or nitrites. Check labels carefully. And if sodium or potassium nitrates or nitrites are listed, don't buy it. And avoid foods that are smoked. Number 5, MSG or monosodium glutamate. MSG is a flavor-enhancing additive that is added to our food. It is a food additive that easily triggers two different types of inflammation and can cause issues with your liver. Foods that are high in MSG include pre-packaged soups, salads, dressing, fast food, and deli meats. So when you are dining out, just ask or look for signs that show you that no MSG is added. And you can always take a look at the labels to avoid foods that contain MSG. Number 6. Gluten. Gluten is a protein found in grains like wheat, barley, rye, and spelt. It gives the flour a glue-like property. That is where the name gluten comes from. Most people can tolerate it, but some people are allergic to it. It triggers inflammation in them. In people with celiac disease, which is the most severe form of gluten intolerance, it triggers autoimmune response. And it damages small intestines, which creates severe nutritional deficiencies. Fortunately, gluten-free alternatives are available easily in the market. Just make sure that they don't include wheat, barley, or rye. Number 7. Aspartame. Aspartame is an added sweetener that contains no nutritional value or calories. It's often used in foods that are sugar-free. But one of the problems with aspartame is that a lot of people's bodies react very negatively to it and treat it like a foreign substance. And they try to attack it with their autoimmune system. And when that happens, that causes an inflammatory response. So foods that are marketed as sugar-free as healthy option, like diet sodas or sugar-free candies or sugar-free drinks, can actually cause a pretty big inflammatory response in a lot of individuals. So to avoid that, you can just look for foods that contain no added sweeteners or no artificial sugars. Number 9. Omega-6. While our bodies do require certain level of omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids, which are contained in vegetable oils and seed oils, having too much omega-6 fatty acids can actually cause an inflammatory response. And a lot of people eat foods that are high in vegetable oils and seed oils. Store-bought salads contain a lot of these oils. Instead, eat foods that contain healthy oils like avocado oil, olive oil, and coconut oil. And these are much better options to avoid inflammatory response. Number 10. Alcohol. Excessive alcohol consumption on a regular basis is toxic. It puts stress on the liver to remove those toxins. And it becomes difficult for the liver to remove all those toxins from the body. And these toxins create an excessive inflammatory response. So the easy way to reduce that is just reduce your alcohol consumption. Okay guys, I hope this video was helpful to you. After knowing about inflammatory foods, you can decide what to eat and what not to eat, and reduce inflammation to stay away from chronic diseases. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share this video. Thank you.